Hi everyone, and welcome to Lesson 33. My name is Danielle. Thank you for joining me today. Let's remember together, last lesson, we discovered that length can be more than just how long something is. Remember, we can measure how long, how tall, how deep, how wide, or how thick something is. How did you go with your home task? I'd like to share what I discovered. So here, I drew my lunchbox. If I'm thinking about the attribute of length, I could measure how tall, how wide, or how long my lunchbox is. I looked at a vase and I thought, oh, what could be measured here? I could measure how tall the vase is, or how deep it is, or how wide it is. Here I drew a texture. I thought that I could think about how thick the tip of the texture is, or I could talk about how long the texture is. Here's my necklace. We could measure how thin the string is, or we could measure how long it is. Here's my welcome mat. I could measure how long it is, how wide it is, or how thick it is. Great job. Remember, we talked about the words that mathematicians might use when talking about the attribute of length. We could use words like these: thin, shorter, shortest, wide, longest, thick, deep, tallest, short, longer, narrow, long, shallow, and tall. These words help us when we are measuring and comparing. Our learning intention today is to accurately use informal measuring tools. Let's get started. When we measure, we use informal and formal measuring tools to help us be more accurate and to compare. I have some measuring tools here I'd like to show you. I have some Unifix cubes, some pop sticks, a ruler, a tape measure, a sewing measure, and some paper clips. Do you notice that some of these tools have numbers or marks that are evenly spaced? I wonder what that's for. I need your help now. We're going to sort them into formal and informal tools. Okay, you're going to help me sort them. We're going to put the formal tools here and the informal tools here. Let's have a look at the pop sticks. There's no lines or marks there. I think they would be informal. I'm going to put them here. Now, the measuring tape. I can see evenly spaced lines. This must be formal. What about the paper clips? I'm going to put them here, informal. The ruler, that's definitely got some numbers and lines to help. Let's put that here. And our Unifix cubes, what do you think? I think so too, informal. And finally, our sewing tape. Let's put that with formal. You might notice that on the formal measuring tools, there are numbers and lines. These help us line up and measure the units of length. Let's take a closer look at our informal measuring tools. What do you notice? Did you notice that they are all the same size? All the Unifix cubes are the same, as well as the pop sticks and our paper clips. Could we use shells as an informal measuring tool? What do you think? Let's have a look at some shells. What do you notice? Yeah, we can't use shells because they're all different sizes, and this wouldn't be an accurate tool to measure. Before we use these formal measuring tools, we have to know how to use the informal measuring tools like Unifix, pop sticks, and paper clips. Today, we are going to practice using informal measuring tools. I have a book. Now, we know that if we're looking at the attribute of length, we could measure how wide it is or how long the book is. What kind of long should we measure today? I think we'll measure the width or how wide the book is. Now we are going to choose a unit of measure. What do you think would be more appropriate? Pop sticks or matchsticks? Because we're measuring the width, I'm going to use matchsticks because they're smaller and it might help me to be more accurate. Okay, so what I need to do is start at the beginning of the object, which is here. And I'm placing my matchsticks very carefully. I have to make sure that I am placing the matchsticks in a straight line. I'm lining them up so they're touching. What do you think about that? They're touching. Oh, hang on. We need to remember that they need to touch, but they can't be overlapping. See how this matchstick here is overlapping the other one. That's not accurate. Let's fix it. Here we are. Okay, I'm continuing to measure the whole book. How did I go? Pretty accurate? Now, let's count the matchsticks to find out our total. Count with me. 1, 2, 3, 4. So now it's really important to state the unit of measure and what we measured. Like, my book is 4 matchsticks wide. Let's record this. First, I'm going to get a fresh piece of paper. I'm going to draw my book. Then I'm going to draw the matchsticks carefully lined up. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now I'm going to write a sentence. I'm going to write, my book is 4, that was our total, 4 match, that was my unit of measure, matchsticks. And what kind of long did we measure? Yes, the width or how wide. My book is 4 matchsticks wide. Great job. Let's try this in another way. Now I want to measure my drink bottle. What kind of long should we measure now? Let's measure how tall it is. This time, my unit of measure is Unifix cubes. If I'm measuring how tall, I need to stack them very carefully, one on top of the other. Help me count. 1, 2, I'm making sure that they're touching but not overlapping. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, count with me, 6, we're measuring the whole object, 7, 8, 9, 10, is that enough? No. 11. 12. What do you think? Maybe one more? Now, we're up to 12. Let's count on 13. So my sentence would be, my drink bottle is 13 Unifix cubes tall. Let's record. First, I'll draw my drink bottle. Here's my drink bottle. And here, I'm just going to draw a line here and make that my 13 Unifix cubes. And then I'll write my sentence. My bottle is how many? 13. That was our total. My bottle is 13. Now our informal unit of measure was Unifix cubes. Unifix cubes. And what kind of long? Tall. My bottle is 13 Unifix cubes tall. Well done. So let's think about some rules or some top tips to remember when measuring length. I've made a list here. And it says top tips for measuring length. Top tip number one, work out what attribute you need to measure. When we looked at the book, we had to think about whether we were going to measure how long it was or how wide it was. Tip number two, choose the best informal measuring tool. Remember, we looked at the popsticks and the matchsticks, and we thought that the smaller matchsticks would be more accurate when measuring the width of the book. Oh, tip number three was no curvy lines. So when we were measuring the width, we made sure that we were placing the matchsticks in a nice straight line. Tip number four, no gaps or overlaps. So we need to remember that the matchsticks are touching but not overlapping. Tip number five, measure the whole object. So we start here and we keep measuring the whole object. Tip number six, say the total and the unit after measuring. So here we would say, my book is 4 matchsticks wide. Your home task is to find 2 or more objects to measure. You need to find something at home that is the same size to be your informal measuring tool, like the matchsticks or straws. You could record like I did. Remember our top tips when you are measuring. Today, we have worked out some top tips for measuring accurately using informal measuring tools. Have fun exploring this at home. I'll see you next time.